Welcome to the final video in the Back Keyser Bar build series. In this video, I complete the wiring and the final assembly. This is the LED strip light that I mounted above the menu. The nice thing about this one is there's marked spots on there where you can cut it to length. So after you figure out exactly how long you run, you just cut it with wire cutters. I had a hole in the side of the collar to run wires through. This one is the wire for a PC fan. It's very low voltage, but they're designed to run constantly. And it's not a loud fan, and it really gives you enough airflow to make sure that the cool air is getting pulled up into the collar and keeping those beer lines cold. This is another one of those parts where it worked, but there's probably an easier way to do it. This is me making the bat signal. I put a flashlight in a PVC piece of tubing and then cut out a little bat logo, and then I taped this to the top of the PVC for it to properly project onto the ceiling. And then I just bought a real small low-powered USB light that I wired to put in the back of this thing. Originally, I had a pen light that I had drilled a hole for that sat behind this logo. After I put all this together, the pen light didn't dissipate enough and it wasn't bright enough. I ended up taking this piece off and using the same LED strip light that I used to light up the menu. It actually ended up working out better because it was brighter, and I could also match the color of the menu because the LED strip lights allow you to change the color and the brightness, whereas this pen light did not. I spent a good amount of time actually working on this little bat signal light on the back. It was probably a simpler way to do this, but this was really cheap. And at this point, I was coming towards the end of the project, so I figured, what the heck, just keep working on it and get it done. I used chalkboard paint on the piece of wood that I was using for the menu. This worked out good, but with the chalkboard paint and using liquid chalk pens, eventually it started to stain, and the ink would show through whenever I tried to erase it. So I ended up replacing this menu with a piece of plastic that I just painted the back black, so it's glossy and it cleans up completely whenever I wipe off the liquid chalk. Again, I'm using some leftover grout, sand grout that I had from the kitchen project. Mix it up a little bit thinner so it would be easier for me to jam into the cracks, and also because you're not walking around on this like a floor, it's just for decoration. The whole thing is finally coming together. Doing the last bit of cleanup on the top and the sides, wiping everything down and getting it prepped for final assembly. I put this foil tape all over the inside of that insulation. I didn't really need to do this, but I am glad I did because it does make it easier to keep clean and it just makes it look more uniform. When you're sliding in the taps and the shanks, you want to make sure that you hit that like and subscribe. It helps out my channel, bumps up my videos, and I really appreciate it. After I redid the light with the strip light the LED came in, the bat logo lights up a lot brighter. It actually gave the look that I wanted. For the tap handles, I bought these kits that come with a piece that you screw into the tap handle, and then you could screw on the bottom to attach it to the faucet. The tricky part was getting it lined up so that the tap handles faced forward. Now I'm just lining it up so that when I screw them in, they all line up straight. I glued carpet sliders onto the bottom of this. I did four originally, and then I had to add a bunch more because once I put all the kegs in there, this thing was really heavy and four sliders wasn't cutting it. I cut all my beer lines the same length. The advantage of using those Purelik adjustable flow faucets is that I don't have to deal with adjusting the beer lines based on the carbonation or the style of beer that I'm pouring. I can just adjust the flow rate at the top. I was told that if you just maintain your beer lines and you keep them clean, you never have to replace them, but I didn't want to risk it. And that's another reason why I set this up so that I could take that top off if I had to get access to the shanks to replace these beer lines if I needed to. I labeled all of my beer lines, 1, 2, and 3, so it made it easy for me to put kegs in and know exactly which line I was connecting to them for which tap up top, and I didn't have to deal with tracing lines later on. And I did some dry fitting here to figure out the exact positioning of all these kegs and the CO2 tank. This is my 3-pressure manifold. I got 3 kegs in here. I wanted versatility on my geyser bar since I'm building this once. This allows me to set individual pressure for each 3 kegs. So if I'm doing different styles of beer that I want at different carbonation levels, I can adjust it here. This is another CO2 line that I'm running out the side of the bar. I use this for putting CO2 on my kegs if I'm gonna have to store them in the fridge for a little while before I actually tap them, and I can use it to force carbonate it if I'm in a hurry. I made my actual menu removable. One, it's a lot easier to pull this out to draw the art on it whenever you're writing down what beer's on tap, and it makes it a lot easier to clean. Plus, I can remove this when I'm cleaning out my taps themselves so it's not splashing beer onto the menu and smearing everything. And this is the way I made that bat signal cast onto the ceiling. Cut out a really small little bat symbol, put on a piece of clear tape, taped it at the end of this tube, and the light that shoots behind this gives just enough of a clear pattern that it looks like the bat signal cast up onto the sky from the movie. I'm using this semi-rigid USB extension thing I found on Amazon. This is what I ran through the hole, but it allowed me to support the light itself just by plugging it in here and aiming it whatever direction I wanted it to hit the ceiling. It would hold in place fine, but it allowed me to adjust it later if I needed to move it. I went ahead and put some chains on the sides just to make sure that when this thing was fully open, the weight wasn't all being held by the hinge. After I put the whole lid together and put that coffin top on, I realized how much weight was actually sitting on that thing whenever it was open, and I just felt a lot better having a second secure method to take the load off of those hinges. Couple things I changed since this initial build. One, when my freezer died and I got the new one, I flipped it so that the front was actually facing the back of this. That allowed me access to the drain port on the freezer so that when I get condensation buildup, instead of me having to use a pump to get it out of the bottom, I could just pump it out through the drain line that's actually built into the freezer. The other thing that I did, I put a false bottom in the bottom of this whole thing to sit the kegs on top of, so that whenever it does start to get a lot of condensation and freeze up, my kegs are sitting above that and not sitting in the water at the bottom of this thing. I had the space to do it, and it makes it a lot easier when this freezes to try and pull kegs in and out, and also to de-thaw it and drain it. While you're finishing up your geyser build, make sure you hit that like and subscribe. I really appreciate it. One power cord runs the whole thing. Everything goes through that controller and the electro wiring I put on the inside. You you see all my lights work. They look a little better in the dark. There it is, the final product. Well, mainly the final product. It's like I said, I did a couple of modifications between this original build and now, but that is it. The controller allows me to adjust the temperature that I want this thing to sit at for serving my beer. And when I want to defrost it, I just turn that off, let everything melt in there, and drain it out the back. If you guys are even contemplating building yourself a Keyser bar, I would say do it. This was a lot of fun to make. Definitely a great way to serve your homebrews. And I get a lot of compliments on it when people come over. I hope this video gave you guys some ideas for building a Keyser bar of your own. And if you're on the fence about doing it, I hope that the tutorial I gave kind of made it easier and gave you the courage to go ahead and go for it. Because it was a lot of fun to do. And as always, keep brewing.